Anyway, actually, I have one laser here and three other laser projectors. I can use any of those. And what I will show now is how to dispatch some long contents on multiple lasers. So that's my powerful one. I will decrease a bit the power. Okay. So it's quite distorted. I will first make a surface on the one that is less distorted. Let's make. I will try to make it a bit higher. Okay. Ah, shit. Okay. So that is my laser wall tam. I will adjust it with this grid to get something a bit clean up. Okay. Maybe a bit smaller so that all lasers fit this area. And now I can so I can do perspective. So I can adjust in perspective my laser quad, but I can also do mesh warping. And if I enable mesh warping, then I can click to add a warping point and then adjust my output to avoid this distortion. I can add more warping point. There is a shortcut, a keyboard shortcut, which is Alt plus A. If I press Alt plus A somewhere, then I can distort at that point. And all actions can be undone with Command Z. Undo redo is undone for all changes you do in my mapper. Bim bim bim. Okay. That's my first. That's the tam actually. I will do another one E and I will try to match the tam. Okay, I won't spend too much time, but if I zoom with my mouse, then it's a bit easier to adjust. But then you can see the camera, so I will avoid doing very precise stuff that you cannot see. Okay. So actually, ManMapper is driving four lasers with four different protocols. And if I unplug, replug the laser projectors, the DAC, I mean, they will be found again and reconnected in real time. So actually, that's the laser cube, and the laser cube has a smaller angle, so I will not be able to match my grid here. And this one is the okay. Oops. The laser wall DS1000, which is quite affordable and not very powerful, so it's cool for testing, for prototyping, for working at home or experimenting. Okay, so actually it's not that bad. On the camera you cannot see that it's not perfect, but it's almost perfect. Okay, here, that one a bit down. Okay, there is a big difference in those ones. In the middle. Okay, let's say it's okay. So I have my this one is on the tarm. Okay, this one is on the Unity. It's too powerful. I will reduce the power of this one, and this one is on the TS1000. This one Can be up, but yeah, the colors and the beam shape of the three lasers are different, so you don't see that, but it's not really nice looking at it. It's better to do a dispatching with the same beam, same colors. Actually, now what I want to show you is that I can create a fifth projector, laser projector here. That I will call a composition. Okay, and that one I will remove the safety area so I can use the wall size of my projector. And instead of assigning it to a real destination, I will publish internal loopback on it, and I want to dispatch content being there on three loopbacks, and I will show you what it does. So if now I take my laser text surface, I put it on my composition here, I use the wall area, I put it white. Okay, let's remove the laser beam preview, I don't need that, and I will set it to adjust font to fit. Magnum bumper. Okay, some problems. Okay, dispatching. Okay, and I center. Okay, now, so this laser surface is on a laser projector that is not assigned to a real physical device, but which I publish and I say to dispatch on three medias that I can reuse, and they are called composition 1, 2, and 3. And then since I adjusted all my laser surfaces with the grid so that they match in the space, I can choose to use composition 1E, composition 2E, and composition 3E, and so each of the I take all surface. It's quite dark. It's quite dark because here it's already dark. And okay, I can increase. Now you can see that I've got the DS 1 watt here on the left, and the other ones are burning the camera, so I will just adjust a bit the luminosity on each surface, and you can see that there is a big colorization difference. So on the Unity, I can go to the Unity and adjust the color levels to remove some red and green and have more blue, and then go back here and increase a bit. Well, if I fiddle a bit with the parameters, I can get good things. And now I have 60 frames on my laser surfaces displaying the text, because the content is being dispatched over all my surfaces, and I can try to type more text, and until I'm over 45 FPS, it's a bit cool enough, it doesn't seem to flicker at the for your eyes. Okay, pim-pam-pim-pam-pim, there is one, it is actually, okay. Okay, and so now if I change stuff in this place, this is where I create, and the content I create here will be dispatched over all my surfaces. And I can use some other, I can add some line surface, for instance, here on the composition, and the line surface.